to help us with this move that we're seeing in both WTI and Brent. John, is this all Iran, pretty much?
Oh, definitely, Melissa. I mean, it's a measured response. I mean, a percent, you know, a tweet like that from President Trump or any U.S. president, that directly challenging the Iranians, you know, it's good for a good dollar. That's what we're getting about here, dollar a barrel. Because, you know, you start to put on your analysis, your thinking cap about, you know, what the prospects are here. And, you know, given the ingredients are there for any number of things to happen, especially as this Trump administration, you know, seems to be pushing for regime change. That's the end game here with the renewed sanctions. And we have John Bolton in the administration. We know during the Bush administration he pushed hard for an attack on Iran directly. We know that the Israelis are pushing for it, and the Saudis would not be opposed to it, let's put it that way. So it's a red-hot cauldron.
Walk us, John, if you can, through the steps in escalation that we could see that could impact the oil market. I mean, logically, the next step would be that the U.S. could stop providing waivers on sanctions to its European allies when dealing with Iran. I mean, Iran could also close the Strait of Hormuz and sort of cut off the supply of oil from that part of the world.
And that's the real question, Melissa. Does Iran get pushed so deeply into a corner that they see it as having no choice but to really go effectively nuclear, which is to try and close the Strait of Hormuz? Just to give some geography background on that, it is a basically 2 1-mile wide shipping lanes. U.S. Navy has historically acknowledged Iran's ability to close the strait, but they've also quickly said that they could unblock the strait if anything were to occur. Keep in mind, the bulk of Saudi Arabia's oil goes through the strait. All of Kuwait's, all of UAE's oil goes through the straits, about 40% of the world's oil. So, but that is really seen as, again, the nuclear option for Iran, because they would not only be alienating, obviously, all those other countries I just mentioned, but what it would do to the oil market, send prices, you know, to the several hundred-dollar mark, would obviously impact the few friends they have in terms of the Europeans. So there's a question there as to how Iran would truly go that far. But for now, the Iranians have put down August 6th as a drop-dead date for the Europeans to come up with a plan to move forward, and things will start to get hotter from there.
Let's say there are no sanctions granted to our allies in dealing with Iran. How much would that add to the price of oil? Let's say Iran goes the nuclear option. How much would that then add? And let's use Brent. It's trading at around $74 right now.
Yeah, so I don't see the administration granting a single waiver.
Okay.
They are taking a very hard stance on this.
Is that priced in already?
No, not yet.
Okay.
I think there's a lot of hopeful analysis out there that it would be too harmful to the economy and to the administration's position to go that far. But that's what we started to see, this price run up last month when we saw Brent prices get over 80 and WTI get back over 75.
Right.
So
okay.
We would see the inexorable march towards 90 bucks at least for Brent as these sanctions as the sanctions on Iran take place. The numbers on a blockage or any kind of upset or military situation in the Strait of Hormuz, that is off to the races. Pick your number, 150, 200.
Huh.
It goes sky high, Melissa, because we are talking about an abject shortage of oil than
right.
in the global market.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.